Hello. Right, so we're gonna continue the tutorial with Adobe Illustrator. So hopefully you already installed Adobe Illustrator. What you have here is a screen, opening screen that it asks you to choose what size of the document that you want. So for this particular purpose, we're going to pick A3 size. You can do so by go to create new. It will ask you what kind of document that you want. You go to print, and then once you go to print, you pick A3, okay, and then you pick orientation, landscape, okay. Perhaps a bit more setting. You don't want it to be like high because it would require a lot of memory. Just put it for now medium, okay. So again, A3 size. Portrait, landscape orientation, medium, the rest just remain as it is. It doesn't really matter whether it is CMYK or RGB. For now, let's do that. Can then quit. Okay, so what you have now is A3 landscape layout. So A3 is basically two A4, right? So the exercise, on the sketchbook that we did just now is A4 size, so it is for one page, and then we need another page. Okay, we're going to design similar layout here. So first of all, you can bring out your ruler. Okay, so right now it didn't have a new ruler here. So to bring out a ruler, it's simply by pressing Ctrl R, or you can also press Command R. If you're using Mac, you can Command R. If you're using Windows, you can press Control R. Okay, once you click Control R or Command R, the ruler will come out. You can see that. Alright, so an A4 size length is around 42 cm. Right now, the measurement here, I'm not sure, I think it is under pixel. So what you can do, you can hover your mouse on top of this ruler here. This is your mouse, make sure this one is selected, selection, and go on top of it, not here, not here, okay, on top of the ruler, right click and then pick centimeter. Okay, so the length of A3 size is usually 42 cm. So in order to make it A4, we can divide it into 2, which is 42 divided by 2, which is 21. So we're gonna stop at 21, which is somewhere here. So we need to bring the guide, okay, from left side here, hover over the ruler on the left side here, click and hold your mouse, click and hold your mouse, and then drag until it meets the 21 point, which is somewhere here, 1. So now the page is divided into 2. So we have page 1, page 2, of if it's in the middle, page 19 and page 20. Okay. So now following the example that we have done just now, okay, or I've done just now, okay, you can select the type tool. In order to type, we can just put text box. My text box here is rather small. I'm gonna make it big. Okay. Then I'm going to double click, then type title. Okay. Now the layout is essential. What you can do, normally I would use classic. Okay, essential classic. So with this, you will have a lot of more options up here. Okay, so you highlight the title just now, and then perhaps increase the size a bit by clicking on this character. Instead of 12 points, perhaps you want it to be a bit bigger. I would do around 72 points. Okay, now it is on the left side, so I want it to be slightly in the middle, or in the middle, then I just click on align center, so it will be in the middle. there. Right, pattern over here. Then what we have, okay, we can add the we can divide the page even more, because what we did just now in the particular example of sketches, we have 4 columns per page, okay, which is actually arguably quite a lot of columns, but it's fine for this purpose. So I'm going to divide here. Okay, again, similar method. I'm just going to hover my mouse on the ruler. I click and hold my mouse and then I drag. Right. So for this, you don't really have to measure using like pinpoint accuracy. It's just that if you feel that the left side and the right side and the left side and the right side is somewhat similar size, you can just put your guide over there. So right after the title, we have one big landscape. You can just put the landscape picture over there. Okay, perhaps color it with some color. I would usually use gray color. So gray color here. Okay, that's one picture. If you want it to be much more cleaner, then perhaps you can also complete the guide, okay, on the margin side. Okay, I would just create a margin over here, top, bottom, left and right. So this one I will give around 2 cm. Okay. So I don't make it too close to the part here, because this is going to be space between the column. So I'm just going to make it around, like, I don't know, 0.5 cm, something like this. Yeah, so if it's a bit difficult to manage this guide, you can turn off, okay, the snap to point. So I go to view, and then now snap to point is selected. I just unclick this, and then you can just, okay, you can just simply arrange it like this. Okay, so that's one picture, and then we have 5 squares. So I'm just gonna do 1 square over here. And then these squares I'm going to give copy paste 4 more times to have 5 more squares. Okay, which is somewhat here. Right, and then this one I'm going to copy. To select both, we can just hold shift, select 1, select 2, Ctrl C, Ctrl V to paste. So that's the shortcut. Apparently, like, this side here is much more than this side, so I'm gonna rearrange this guide here. So we can go to view. Now the guide, okay, is selected perhaps. So you can just put here, rearrange this a bit. Okay, this one I'm gonna resize it. Control V again. Okay, they are now, yeah, they are now equal in size. Good. Okay, and then we have another one somewhere here. Right. Okay, you can also pull the guide to make sure that the boxes are similar, okay, aligned properly. If you don't want it, then you can click the guide. One click delete, okay, the guide will be gone. Alright, so we have now fulfilled the pictures, 1 portrait big, and then 5 square small, and then we have 6 subtitles. Okay. So perhaps this is the first subtitle. Subtitle 1, okay, not this big, perhaps just this big. You can resize by double click, and then you can pick character, and then you can pick maybe a more comfortable size for a subtitle, probably around 14 points. Okay, so somewhere here, perhaps. Subtitle 1. Perhaps this one is subtitle 2. Okay. And copy and paste. Bring it somewhere here for subtitle 3. Okay, and then 3, 4. As for the column, you can perhaps create a text box. Okay, just do it like so to fill this column. And then if you're using a new version of CC, perhaps this is going to be auto-fill. We can just rearrange it to perhaps go to the left, arrange paragraph to the left. Okay, perhaps also you don't want this kind of dash here, which is hyphen. You can do so, or you can eliminate it by click on paragraph and then untick hyphen it. And then instead of this one, okay, under paragraph, instead of this one, perhaps you want to justify by clicking the middle one here. So let's justify. Then you can also do next column. Maybe a bit. Okay. There. This is just dummy. Yeah? And then another column is just to fit the bottom column down here. Okay, I won't bother with filling up the rest because I can just copy and paste. So I'm just copy and paste and put it somewhere here. These two I can just copy and paste and put it somewhere here. Alright, so we have our page now, seems like it's ready. Okay, we have title, perhaps this title can be a bit bigger. Right now it is 72, perhaps I want it to be 101. Oh, this is 1000. One over one, enter. Okay. Maybe main title instead. Alright, so looks nice. Okay, so we have main title, we have big picture, we have subtitle 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Six. I'm just going to select all of them by holding shift key and click, and then I'm gonna maybe turn this into bold instead. So my right pro maybe Helvetica bold. Alright, that looks very nice. Bit of the arrangement. Okay, so that's the first pitch ready. Oh, I forgot another one, which is the page number. The page number, put it here. Page 10 perhaps. We can make it a bit smaller. Usually it's around 6 to 8 points. I'm going to make 8 points. Page 10. So I'm just going to put it here. Perhaps something like this. There you are. Okay. Okay, so for this particular part here, it's for balance. Okay, you can change balance. Right. So next one, using the same layout, you can do perhaps proportion, right? So you can just type, okay, transfer it here, and then type proportion. Okay, so as for proportion, I'm going to give example, sketch example in the brief, so you can just check it out and then create your own proportion. So if you don't understand what is proportion, please refer back to the slides that I've given you and the lecture that I've given you also last week. Right? So you also have another a few more sequence, unity, and contrast apart from balance and proportion. Okay. So for this, I need only two layout like this. Not a layout, just one layout in A3 size, but two page of A4. You can pick and choose if you want balance with proportion, or maybe proportion with sequence, or unity with contrast, up to you, right? Just that right now, I just show you balance and proportion, okay? But then you can do balance and unity, balance and contrast, or proportion and sequence, up to you. Okay, so that is all for the tutorial for week 2 when it comes to the digital version of it. Okay, please refer to the sketch version. So with the sketch version, you have to design all 5 of them, and then for the digital version, you just do 2 version of them. You pick and choose, okay, which one that you want. So that is all. Thank you. I'll see you guys in the next tutorial. Bye bye.